I just saw a very strange straw man made of people who criticize the negative aspects to Abrahamic religion. It's claiming that in order to view Abrahamic religion so negatively, that you have to believe that the driving force of Abrahamic religion itself is the hatred of other people. Now, I don't think I've ever met anyone religious who matches that kind of thing. I've never met anyone who their driving force is hatred. It's generally of love. Nor can I recall ever hearing or seeing any anti-religious people use the argument that hatred is the driving force of people who are religious. I don't see that argument coming from people. I mean, I've obviously seen plenty of religious people say hateful things, but their hatred is simply not the driving force of why they have the spiritual beliefs they do. I mean, I suppose this is just a big misunderstanding of what people don't like about religion. Nowhere in the Bible does it say that you should hate women and treat them like shit. I mean, there are some rules and punishment, right? But it's not this element where you should just, by default, treat women like shit. But there are obviously plenty of places in the Bible that dictate very strict gender roles for women and very strict gender roles for men. The roles for men are that they should be in charge, and the roles for women is that they should be subservient to the men. Most of the people who hold these viewpoints about what roles people should follow do not hold these beliefs in malice or hate. They just think it's the proper roles for people, assigned by God. But, you know, plainly these roles are oppressive to women. You can claim that it empowers them all you want because, well, they'll know their proper place, and when people know their place, then they can achieve more in life or something like that. You know, they can work within those boundaries better. You know, you learn the confines that you're supposed to live under and then work within those, and you'll live your best life, right? Well, sorry, that's still oppressive to people. The end result, in action and what is expected out of women, is sexism and in some cases misogyny. That women should have less power than men by default. But misogyny isn't the goal of these people. The people who hold these beliefs might even be mortified at the very notion that their beliefs are misogynistic. But the same applies to, you know, countries in the Middle East that force women to cover their face or don't let them drive. They claim it's for women's benefit, it's for their protection, and so on. They claim it's not hateful at all, and they get offended when you claim that it is hateful. Well, I mean, anyone can, really from the outside anyway, not anyone who's not living in those countries can look at this from the outside and see, yeah, that's pretty hateful, that's pretty oppressive to women. So let's move on to how Abrahamic religions view homosexuality. Many of the people who say, you're going to burn in hell for eternity, aren't actually saying it because they hate gay people. Now, obviously, there are plenty of religious people who hate gay people. Let's take Westboro Baptist, for instance, as a really extreme example, right? They exist. But most people who suggest that gay people will go to hell are saying it because they honestly believe that homosexuality is a choice, and that those choices will hurt those people in the end because God disapproves of it. So it's supposedly more of a plea to gay people, this notion that, I don't want you to burn in hell for eternity. Please change your sexual orientation so God won't punish you. I love you. I don't want to see you suffer. Now, the problem with that is, well, the reality of things. People don't choose their sexual orientation. And to tell people that they need to change something that they can't change or suffer, yeah, that's bullying, that's harassing. And yes, the end result is that you're preaching hateful religious ideologies. Ideologies that are the number one cause of suicides among LGBT. Yes, those beliefs are both hateful and harmful. Regardless of whether hatred is the driving force behind the spiritual beliefs of the people saying it. Telling people they're going to burn in hell, whether it's done with love or not, is still hate speech. I don't think you should be arrested for it, but it's still hate speech. You see, this is the problem with religion. As it has been said, with or without religion, good people can behave and do good things, and bad people can do evil. But for good people to do evil, that takes religion. So these are some of the arguments against Abrahamic religion. It's clearly not saying that the driving force behind people's spiritual beliefs is hatred. So I hope I've thoroughly destroyed that straw man. Thanks for watching.